Do you love waking up to a hot cup of coffee? Or maybe you're more of a tea drinker? These are two of the most popular drinks in the world. Americans drink about 146 billion cups of coffee per year, whereas in other countries, such as the UK, tea is the clear winner. Both drinks can give you a feeling of alertness and help you wake up in the morning. However, is one better for you than the other when it comes to improving blood pressure? We're going to discover the health benefits each drink has to offer, if there are any risk factors to consider if you have hypertension, and our top tips for ensuring you get the most out of your beverage. Join us as these two drinks battle it out. But first, if you haven't already, please take a second to like this video and subscribe to our channel. We've got amazing new content each week. Also, stick around because later in this video, we'll show you how to receive two free gifts on us. Sitting down and enjoying a hot coffee may help you feel energized and productive. It's also a great way to break up the day and catch up with friends or work colleagues. But is this beverage the best choice? Let's look at our first contender and learn its top health benefits. The first benefit of coffee is that it can help with weight loss. Black coffee has little to no calories in it and can act as an appetite suppressant. Studies have shown that caffeine may increase the number of calories you burn by 3 to 13%. Over a 3-hour period, this translates to anywhere between 79 and 150 calories. This obviously varies with the amount of caffeine you drink. Another reason coffee can help with weight loss is thought to be due to its content of something called chlorogenic acid. This is believed to help inhibit the production of fat cells. Interestingly, an Indonesian study looked at 504 individuals and found that those who regularly drank coffee had lower amounts of body fat. So why is this important when it comes to high blood pressure? According to health guidelines, losing weight can lower both systolic, top number, and diastolic, bottom number, blood pressure readings, and can potentially eliminate high blood pressure. For every 20 pounds you lose, you can drop systolic pressure from 5 to 20 points. Another benefit of coffee is its antioxidant content. These include hydrocinnamic acids and polyphenols. Antioxidants assist in keeping our cells healthy and help get rid of free radicals that cause damage to cells. Keeping cells healthy is a key part of a healthy cardiovascular system and avoiding conditions such as high blood pressure. How about the nutrients contained in coffee? One cup of coffee provides vitamin B2 and 5 called riboflavin and niacin. Both are important for the conversion of energy from food. Niacin also helps release a chemical called prostaglandin. This chemical helps to dilate blood vessels, which improves blood flow and blood pressure. Further nutrients can be found in trace amounts in coffee. These are vitamin B3, manganese, magnesium, and potassium. Both magnesium and potassium assist in the regulation of blood pressure. Magnesium aids in the dilation of blood vessels, and potassium helps the body get rid of excess sodium. Excess sodium can cause fluid retention, which can lead to elevated blood pressure. Thus, potassium is crucial for avoiding hypertension. Another reason coffee can be beneficial is that it appears to reduce the risk of type 2 diabetes. Type 2 diabetes is characterized by high blood sugar and a reduced ability to produce insulin. But coffee drinkers seem to be less likely to develop this disease. This is good news for preventing cardiovascular disease, as high blood sugar is often associated with high blood pressure. This is due to a process called glycation. Glycation is when cells become coated in sugar. When this occurs, our blood can no longer flow with ease. This can lead to hypertension. A 2017 review of studies on coffee concluded that, in the long run, it can have a positive effect on individuals with hypertension, arrhythmia, cardiovascular disease, and cardiomyopathy. We've looked at the benefits of coffee, but what are the things we need to be careful of when it comes to this beverage? Firstly, coffee that isn't organic can contain high levels of pesticides. More chemical fertilizers are sprayed on coffee than nearly any other crop in the world. Thus, drinking conventional coffee means you're consuming these chemicals. These have been directly linked to cancer, heart disease, and disrupting hormones. Furthermore, coffee can contain mold, which may release something called mycotoxins. Mycotoxins can build up in the body and, although not related to high blood pressure, can still result in serious disease. Additionally, if you're trying to reduce your caffeine intake, you may be opting for a decaffeinated variety, but it's important to note how this type of coffee is made. The beans are soaked in a chemical solvent that leaches out the caffeine. This process has been found to increase fatty acids. These may affect metabolic syndrome and increase the risk of cardiovascular disease. Having high levels of toxins in the body can increase risk of hypertension. Therefore, if you want to drink decaf, be sure to use one that extracts the caffeine with Swiss water processing. This removes caffeine without chemicals, making it a much safer option. Finally, if you love to grab a takeaway coffee, then beware of your coffee cup. Drinking from cups that have a plastic lining that contains BPA can be harmful to your health and specifically blood pressure. So if you do want to get a takeaway coffee, then why not invest in a keep cup made from glass? This will help you limit your toxic load and you still get to enjoy your coffee. Next, let's brew up the facts on our second contender and find out if it has benefits for hypertension. That's coming up in just a moment. But if you want to learn more about heart health, then why not download our free ebook, The Surprising Truth About Fat and Cholesterol? And if you'd really like to understand the full picture for fighting and preventing heart disease, check out episode 1 of The Untold Story of Heart Disease. Both gifts are free and waiting for you now. Just click the link in the description below. Numerous studies show benefits of drinking a range of teas, but we're focusing on black tea. Black tea is from the leaves of the Camellia sinensis plant, the same plant that's used to make green tea. But the leaves are dried and fermented, giving black tea a darker colour and fuller flavour. Like coffee, black tea is caffeinated but has less caffeine than coffee, so for those who are caffeine sensitive, it may be a better option. Tea contains antioxidants called polyphenols. These include catechins, theoflavins and theorubigins, which all help promote health. Of these polyphenols, the most notable is theoflavin, which seems to help with weight loss, blood sugar control and reducing cholesterol, all of which can be beneficial for cardiovascular health and blood pressure. Regarding its ability to support weight loss, this is because it helps inhibit production of a pancreatic lipase, which is linked to fat metabolism. The polyphenols found in black tea also seem to help create gut bacteria diversity. This can help with weight management. As we already mentioned, lower weight seems to help reduce blood pressure and puts less strain on the heart. This is, of course, beneficial for cardiovascular health. Another group of antioxidants that can be found in tea are flavonoids. The regular consumption of flavonoids can help reduce risk factors associated with heart disease. These include high cholesterol, elevated triglyceride levels, obesity, and hypertension. Interestingly, a randomized controlled trial looked at the effect of tea drinking on blood pressure. The participants were either given 3 cups of tea daily for 6 months or a placebo. The trial found that those who drank black tea had a significant decrease in top and bottom blood pressure reading in comparison to the placebo group. Another benefit to drinking tea is how it can affect blood sugar. As we already mentioned, high blood sugar can be linked to poorer blood flow and lead to higher blood pressure. Here is where tea can be beneficial. It can help enhance the use of insulin in the body, which is a hormone that helps carry the sugar around the body. Black tea has also been found to lower blood sugar levels and improve how it is metabolized. Finally, tea contains some key minerals such as calcium, phosphorus, potassium, magnesium, and small amounts of manganese and zinc. These minerals are crucial for health, and as we already learnt, magnesium and potassium play a key role in regulating blood pressure. This may be why a 2013 study concluded that drinking 4 or more cups of black tea per day reduced risk of stroke by 21%. As you can see, tea can be beneficial for hypertension, but let's discover if it has any negative side effects. Firstly, tea contains tannins, These are compounds which can bind to iron in food, which make it difficult to absorb. For those with low iron, drinking tea can worsen the condition, making you feel lethargic and lacking energy. Similarly to coffee, tea can also contain toxins. Two reports by Greenpeace show pesticides are widely present in leading international tea brands from China and India. Toxic chemicals are also found in the tea bags themselves, so be sure to choose organic and opt for loose-leaf tea rather than the bagged variety. When it comes to black tea, it's also used in popular cold beverages such as iced tea and bubble tea. Both of these contain a lot of sugar, which can have negative effects on health, blood pressure, and cardiovascular disease. They also often come in plastic bottles or cups. These contain chemicals that have been found to contribute to hypertension. This is especially true of BPA. Now let's look at how they compare together. Both tea and coffee contain caffeine, which, if too much is consumed, can lead to stress and anxiety. Higher levels of stress and anxiety can increase blood pressure. If you feel jittery after drinking either, then you may want to reconsider how much you're drinking. Caffeine in tea and coffee can also affect sleep. Sleep is critical for a healthy heart. Quality sleep and relaxation can aid in reducing elevated blood pressure. But caffeine can have negative effects on sleep due to how it makes you feel more alert. A lack of sleep can also cause blood sugar to rise, which can have a detrimental effect on blood pressure over time. Tea contains less caffeine than coffee. An average cup of tea contains 47 milligrams of caffeine, and an average cup of coffee contains 95 milligrams of caffeine. So the effect of coffee is obviously more pronounced than tea. However, a few cups of either beverage a day appears to reduce your risk of diabetes. Interestingly, even decaffeinated options seem to have the same effect. Both drinks also seem to moderately protect the heart. A review of 5 trials found that drinking coffee can raise blood pressure, but only for 3 hours after drinking it. Cardiologist Dr. Mark Houston, in his book What Your Doctor May Not Tell You About Hypertension, explains that the studies on caffeine and hypertension are confusing. However, he believes this is because some people are caffeine sensitive. He recommends consuming no more than 100 milligrams of caffeine per day. That's equivalent to 1 cup of brewed coffee and 2.5 cups of black tea. It's also important to consider that caffeine is a habit-forming stimulant. This can make it difficult to stop consuming, and some people can get headaches when they stop having tea or coffee. As you can see, both of these much-loved beverages can have health benefits. But now, which of our contenders comes out on top for improving blood pressure? Well, the evidence points towards tea. But here are top tips to make sure you get the most out of your cuppa. Choose organic tea or coffee over conventional. Don't drink from BPA-lined cups or containers. Limit your caffeine in the afternoon so it doesn't interrupt your sleep. And most of all, whichever you choose to drink, make it a time of relaxation and enjoyment. After all, stress is one of the biggest causes of all diseases. Thanks for watching, and please let us know in the comments below which is your hot beverage of choice. And make sure to stay tuned to Heart Disease Code to discover more wonderful nutrition and wellness insights. Once again, don't leave without grabbing both of your 2 free gifts. Just click that link below. Until next time, have a heart-healthy day.